50 as Orange County's first television station. The evening is divided into two sections. The first will be the dedication ceremonies, and it will be followed by a public open house. We'll be visited by many interesting people. We'd like to have you join us for some scenes from both events.
Welcome to Channel 50. This is a noteworthy event in the illustrious history of Orange County, and we want you to know that we're delighted to have you share this event with us. First, I would like to introduce the members of the Coast Community College Board of Trustees, the President, Mr. William Kettler, Bill, the Vice President, Mr. Worth Keene, and members, Mr. Donald Hoff, Mr. Robert Humphreys, and Mr. George Rada. I would also like to introduce all of the other county leaders, all of the movers and shakers of Orange County who are here with us tonight. But if I did, there'd be no time for program. So therefore, I'll apologize at the outset and simply ask that you turn to your next door neighbor, greet the neighbor, and you'll have met a very important person tonight. Channel 50, Orange County's first public television station, broadcasting in full color, went on the air for the first time on November 20th of last year. It works. The signal is loud and clear. And now we would like to show the people of Orange County the rich new resource which is available to them. Our facilities are the finest. Our staff is highly talented, skilled, and commercially experienced. Our goals are to expand the range of educational opportunities available to the people of Orange County. We plan to offer a wide variety of college-level courses, community affairs programs that reflect the social, intellectual, and aesthetic interests of Orange County, instructional programs designed for preschool, elementary, and secondary school, and telecasting for agencies of local and county government. Higher education worldwide is currently undergoing a period of ferment and change. Non-traditional education is being discussed and tried in many countries and in many colleges in the United States. Such experiments as the University Without Walls, the external degree, the extended campus, and the open university have been designed as models. The Coast Community College District, with the assistance of this outstanding facility, now possesses the potential to take education into every home and office in the community at times which are most convenient for the student. We look forward to working with the other educational institutions in Orange County, as well as with the public agencies, in an effort to broaden the horizons and enrich the quality of life of the people of Orange County. At the present time, the two colleges in the district, Orange Coast College and Golden West College, are working cooperatively with 24 other community colleges in Southern California as a part of the Southern California Consortium of Community Colleges in the production and distribution of television courses of study. In another effort, we have combined forces with the University of California at San Diego, the California State University at San Diego, to design television programs that can be shown at the three segments of higher education in California. In Orange County, we have joined forces with the University of California at Irvine, California State University at Fullerton, Rancho Santiago, North Orange County, Saddleback College, and Chapman College to explore the development of common offerings by means of television. As a member of the League for Innovation of the Community Colleges, we are participating with 15 other community college districts nationwide, exploring once again the production and distribution of educational television courses. We have also combined forces with an institution that was a pioneer in educational television, Chicago City College, as well as with Miami-Dade and the College of San Mateo in a similar effort. The Coast Community College District has accepted the challenge of attempting to realize the powerful potential of television for educational and cultural enrichment. We seek your support and your assistance. To tell you a little bit more about Channel 50, its program and its story, I'd like to introduce at this time the Vice President and General Manager of Channel 50, Bill Furness. Bill?
Well, I've waited a long time for this evening, and now it's here, and I'm very pleased to see it occur. It occurs to me that in this room, there are an awful lot of people that perhaps seem less visible tonight that have had a great deal to do with making Channel 50 come into fruition. It's difficult for me to describe when I look among the room and I see faces of people that I know that have put in many, many hours of work, the feeling of gratitude that I have toward them, because I know that a television station definitely is not a one-man effort. The planning for Channel 50 occurred in the beginning almost a decade ago. There were a number of people, both on the Board of Trustees and on the faculties and staffs of both Orange Coast and Golden West College, that began to ask the question, what can we do with educational television to extend the offerings of our campuses beyond their own boundaries? I think those questions were well asked, and I think the responses were well researched. And the end result is something that we're very pleased to have you come and share with us tonight. I probably would be very remiss if I did not mention several very important people on the staff at Channel 50, because there are faces and people that I want you to get to know. There will be people that you'll be hearing about in the future, and they in turn are some of the key people that I think you need to be aware of, because they are the kinds of people that make Channel 50 work. Very specifically, I want to introduce two people off the management team or from the management team at Channel 50. One gentleman has been here since the very beginning, when the place where you were sitting is nothing but a concrete slab, and came with me from another district to begin the work on this facility. He is now our current Director of Operations and Production, and he's a gentleman I count among one of my closest friends. I'd like to introduce him to you, Mr. Don Gertz, Director of Operations. There is another gentleman that has joined our staff more recently. He came to us from the north, at the Bay Area. At that time, he was acting general manager and also program director for a station in San Jose, KTEH Channel 54. We were fortunate enough to have this gentleman join us most recently, and he will be acting in the capacity of program director. So a good deal of the programming, some of which you'll be seeing a little bit later on tonight, will come directly from the work that he's put in, after Don has had the opportunity with his staff of production people to put together the very fine programs we anticipate and have already been able to produce. It will be the job of the program director to get them scheduled at a time where you will be able to see them. I'd like to introduce at this time our director of programming, Mr. Leo Blyer. Perhaps it would not be a good idea to overlook another gentleman who's put in a lot of work tonight, and he is a more familiar face to a number of us for the years that he has spent working at Channel 2 and Jerry Dumphy's Big News, our Director of Community Services, Jim Cooper, over here in the corner. Not the least of which is the blimp that is flying around outside, and I'm told that Jim holds the insurance policy on the blimp. Because of a decade of work, Channel 50 now is on the air. It began November 20th. Its broadcast schedule is currently from 4 o'clock until 10 o'clock in the evening. Beginning in February, we will start our first college-level courses for credit. At the end of this fiscal year, beginning July, we will go to a six-day-a-week broadcast schedule, and the schedule will continue to expand from there on. on the staff of Channel 50 right at the present time are 32 very, very talented and I think very, very important people. It's taken a good part of 18 months to collect them and put them together. They are essentially the nucleus of the staff. They consist of Emmy Award-winning producer directors. They consist of people in engineering and staffs that have a combined experience of well over several hundred years in the field of broadcasting, both educational and commercial. I think they will provide, and I think it is reasonable to say, a first-rate facility for Orange County. It has been said by a wiser person than myself that genius is the ability to avoid work by doing it right the first time. I think with the staff and the people that we have, you'll see that it can be done right the first time. This evening, a little later on in the program, we're going to present to you some taped excerpts of programs that have already appeared and will appear over Channel 50. I hope that you do not run into the unforeseen circumstance that I've heard of at many meetings so far where someone reaches up to my sleeve and says, by the way, I can't get Channel 50 on my set. What do I do? There are several cable companies, 17 to be exact, in Orange County, many of whom are at the present time picking up our signal. It won't be long, I would guess within another 3 months, before the signal will be reached by every cable company in the county. And our signal, of course, is very, very strong throughout the remainder of the county when received in the open air. We look forward to Channel 50's development with great enthusiasm. And I must confess, by having people such as yourselves who are interested in what we're doing, we are doomed to chronic success. And we're very pleased about that. This evening's messages, comments, will only give you some brief indication of the enthusiasm that we feel. At this time, for the official dedication of Channel 50 to the people of Orange County, I would like to introduce Mr. William Kettler, who is president of the board of the Coast Community College Trustees. Mr. Kettler.
Ladies, gentlemen, honored guests, although we have many important federal, state, county officials with us, I want you to realize that we consider each and every one of you an important and honored guest because you are the community and you are what made this possible. I had a 48-page speech all written, and I asked Dr. Watson to cut it down commensurate with my importance on the program, and this is what I got back. Looks like it's from a Chinese fortune cookie. Says, make little speeches, make big friends. So I will do that. It is a great honor and pleasure to dedicate this. The dedication reads, dedication, the Board of Trustees of the Coast Community College District hereby dedicates KOCE-TV Channel 50, a public broadcasting television station designed to extend the community services and educational opportunities of Coast Community College District. January 31st, 1973, Board of Trustees, Coast Community College District, William Kettler, Worth Keene, Donald G. Hoff, Robert Humphreys, and George Rodden. Thank you.
We have slightly altered the order of our program because our honored guest has a class that he's teaching at Occidental College. He needs to be there at 7 o'clock, and we don't want the instructor to be late. Our honored guest this evening has served as a member of the President's Cabinet for 4 years. He has served as a counselor to the President of the United States. In 1966, he was elected Lieutenant Governor of California with the largest number of votes of any statewide candidate in the nation that year. Ecology was the subject of his 1966 campaign, long before the word became a political byword. In 1968, President Nixon named him as Secretary of Health, Education, and Welfare, the youngest man ever to hold that position. At his suggestion and implementation, the Urban Council was formed with our speaker acting as chairman. During his tenure as Secretary of Health, Education, and Welfare, he propounded the concept of an environmental agency which would act as the enforcing arm of the various bodies working toward the betterment of the environment. This became the Environmental Protection Agency. He was also instrumental in establishing grants under the Educational Broadcasting Facilities Act, under which Channel 50 last year received a grant of $282,000. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great privilege and an honor for me to present a fellow Californian, the former Lieutenant Governor of the state of California, the former Secretary of Health, Education, and Welfare, and Counselor to the President, the Honorable Robert Finch.
Thank you, Dr. Watson, Bill Furness, and Bill Kettler, Ron Caspers, and fellow Californians, friends, all of Channel 50. There's the kind of excitement that marks graduation, a wedding, the big events in one's life, the personal events. And while one, at least I always feel at home in Orange County, one of the things that's exciting about this part of California is its great willingness to reach out and grasp something new and exciting. And when you bring together the college here and look back at the history of American education, which is the history of our pursuit of one of the most radical ideas and yet one of the most simple ideas in human history, which is to give every person a chance to develop to the limit of his or her capability, I think you see what this effort and this marriage tonight is all about. And it's particularly appropriate that the Coast Community College District should be the first to develop a public television station in Orange County, because in that pursuit of education and opportunity for all, an education with lifetime options, nothing is more promising and nothing has better led the way, perhaps in the tradition of the old land-grant colleges, than the concept of the community college. And here in California is where it all came together. As we know, there are millions of potential learners who never have any real contact with school in spite of our extension work and in spite of the great expansion of the community colleges. I'm talking about the dropouts and the handicapped, the migrants, the unemployed, the underemployed, the elderly, the housewives, those in mid-career, and those who simply want to change careers or upgrade their careers, and many, many more among us. And what all of us who are concerned with education are looking for is a design that extends through an individual's lifetime. It's not tied to particular rigid institutions or places or structure or degree, but will serve both a personal and career needs. And of all of the off-campus and technological means devised, what better way is there to expand the influence of education than through the obvious use of television, McLuhan and all? As Dr. Watson pointed out in his position paper on educational television, it has been demonstrated time and time again that effective learning can take place over television, that it does take place whether we like it or not, yet today the use of this for this media for higher education falls dismally short of reaching its potential. We have the technology, and as we walk around this great facility with the video cassettes, the computer information systems, the communication satellites, the two-way communication cables, we know that there's not enough software, and we need to develop programs to so that these facilities can be better able to use them. But the pieces are all here if we can just put them together. And we, all of us, at every level of government and every level of the private sector, need to support experimentation and innovation in educational television so that it is an ever more successful and ever more viable tool. When I was appointed Secretary of Health, Education, and Welfare, there had not been any appropriation for educational broadcasting the previous year. We took that zero and made it $4.5 million the first year, $5 million the next, and $11 million my last budget year at Health, Education, and Welfare. In 1972, the appropriation was $13 million. And I was proud to have had a part in that upward trend. But now, as many of you here know, we may be at a policy, if not a fiscal stalemate, and it's up to all of us to see that we get back on track as educators, as public officials, as individual subscribers. So I'm here to say congratulations. I envy Dr. Watson and all of his associates, all of you here at Channel 50. It's very exciting to be in the start of a great adventure, and certainly that's what we have to describe these first weeks of KOCE's broadcast. And to think this is the first time that Orange County has had its own TV station. It's almost inconceivable that the fastest growing county in California, a county bigger than most states, has been without its own TV station for so long. And now this facility can point the way to new vistas of learning and news and drama and sports, everything to catch the imagination of the man, the woman, the father, the mother, the family. It'll help you with your gardening problems and diet and exercises and stretch your mind to new dimensions. And most important, I think whatever this channel does, it will be with that special tang that marks Orange County, and hopefully not a reheated rehash of some other stations or some other area's scheduling. And that's what's important, that a TV station which comes to birth in a unique place retains that unique quality. And above all, that it's not suffocated under the deadening hand of a centralized federal policy. So I commend all of you here in Orange County's first television station. The challenge is limitless. The potential is limitless. And television is, after all, in the business of pushing back horizons and opening up the sky. Success to Channel 50, and congratulations to you all.
Thank you very much, Bob. We're delighted to have had you with us. Best luck, and I hope you get to class on time. Now, to get back on schedule, we would like to welcome the chairman of the Orange County Board of Supervisors, who is with us this evening, who is going to say a few words on behalf of Orange County, Honorable Ronald Casper. Ron?
Thank you, Dr. Watson. When I talk about honors and distinctions, it certainly is one genuinely for Mayor Lowley, County Supervisor, to appear on the same program with such national leaders as Bob Finch. And I think he said it very eloquently that it was about time that the second biggest county in the state received the resources that it should have to get its message across. And I'm particularly delighted to see Jim Cooper back as head of the Community Affairs Division, because you know, we receive a lot of petitions over where I work, but in this particular case, we sent a petition to CBS when they turned out the lights on Orange County to no avail. However, we came back stronger than ever with our own station, which is certainly many, many people need to be thanked for bringing this Channel 50 KOCE to fruition. And I think it comes at a particular important time when we at the county and all the levels of government are taking the government to the people, and including the people more and more in the decision making. And in order to do that, they just simply have to be informed to a higher degree. And many of the grand juries and many of the critics of the past have criticized the communications gap, and can't we do something about it, hire a public information officer, a press agent, or start another newspaper. Well, there's nothing that you could do more than to have this station come into being to help us try to explain the programs that all of us in Orange County are working together on to cope with our growth problems and the different situations that confront us. So on behalf of the Board of Supervisors, I can genuinely tell you that we welcome Channel 50 and its entire crew, and are looking forward to working with them in the many years to come. Thank you for having me.
Thank you very much, Mr. Caspers. It seems that one of my duties and tasks tonight is to remind you and the audience of the fact that we are very pleased to have you here, and also to remind you of a few activities that are occurring, perhaps that are a little bit obscure to us as we sit in this room. This evening, as this particular program is being offered to you in the flesh, so to speak, we are also taping this particular activity so that we will put together a dedication program that will air over Channel 50 in the next few weeks. It is one minor tragedy that there is a person that is not in this room tonight that I would probably like to call to your attention most specifically, who is very much responsible for helping us be able to not only project the same images that we show on the rear screen projector tonight to you in person, but also that we are able to tape this program, edit the tape, and be able to offer it to you in your homes a little bit later on, a couple of weeks from now. He will be a difficult person to see and to find, because he is a person that has a great deal of responsibility for getting us to the point technically so that we are on the air and even here this evening. He's a gentleman that's currently busy broadcasting our evening schedule out over the air to the 1.6 million people that live in this county. He's a gentleman that was the very first man that I asked to join me at Channel 50, and although he's not in the room, he's within earshot, and he can hear everything that's going on because he's technically making quite sure that it's being produced. That would be our Director of Engineering, Mr. Bob Moffitt, and although he's not here, he knows that you're here, and he knows that we appreciate him. Thank you. There are a few other people that were unable to be here in person tonight, but they did want to send their greetings along to Orange County's first television station. So I'm going to ask the crew here in the room to begin to dim the lights so that we can present to you on film and on tape some other very important people that we thought would want to bring some greetings to us in our first television station here in the county. We're on schedule in the program now, and I'd like to turn now to the California Welcomes Channel 50 videotape and film that we'll show to you on the RP projector. It will take us a moment to bring the lights down. And at the conclusion of this particular film segment, I then would like to ask Dr. Watson to introduce our keynote speaker for the evening. So if we can, we'll bring the lights down and ask you to have a look at our rear screen projector for a moment.
This station will give our Orange County citizens the opportunity to become a greater part of the community through the expanding television media that we've all become so familiar with. I'm most proud to have this opportunity to greet this station, to wish it well, and to offer my help in any way I can to expand this training site, this educational media, this wonderful new arrival to our community. Thank you.
To all the people who have for many years made a very strenuous and finally successful effort to establish Channel 50, I want to offer my complete congratulations for a job well done, because Channel 50 represents that unique opportunity for we in Orange County to have available to us a segment in the important media of television that belongs to us, the people of Orange County, that is functioning in the public broadcasting system, which in and of itself has certain built-in benefits for the people who are the consumers, the users, you and me, as we watch our television sets. And in this system, to have what I hope is a high-quality presentation of important facets of our life in Orange County and the Orange County viewpoint of the whole world around us. So I think that we are doubly blessed in not just having another television station in which we can participate and utilize, but to have a station of this particular type with the public service requirement that is imposed on it, and that therefore we in Orange County will have that media which is oriented toward us, the people of Orange County. And for that, I'm grateful to the people who made the effort. I hope that all of you who will, over the years, enjoy Channel 50 will participate in it, give your opinions and views, pro and con, on the things it does, and as it works out its bugs and becomes a fully functioning segment and an important segment of our entertainment and our educational and informational services in the county. We'll continue to give it input and make it grow into the most important segment and channel that we have available to us. So I wish Channel 50 all the good luck in the world and charge it with the responsibility for fulfilling the high purposes I've just described. Good luck, Channel 50.
I'm pleased to welcome on the air KOCE-TV, California's newest educational station. KOCE will make available to Orange County citizens a powerful and effective supplement to its fine educational institutions. As State Superintendent of Public Instruction, I'm pleased to extend my best wishes.
It's a pleasure for me to thank KOCE-TV, Channel 50 in Orange County, and to congratulate them upon their arriving in Orange County to provide the kind of vital services that I think are of benefit to all of us. The fact that they are an educational television station, that they will bring not only educational but cultural programs, the fact that they will allow countywide service in Orange County, which is one of our fastest growing and largest counties here in California, and the fact that they will, in effect, offer all of you an opportunity to involve yourself in college credit courses, I think is more than enough reason for all of us to be pleased that KOCE-TV is now on the air and operating, and I think should be beneficial for every one of us.
No, I think the opportunity that is coming to Orange County through the medium of KOCE Channel 50, Public Broadcasting Service, is something new and very wonderful, a great opportunity for all of the citizens and all of the communities and all of the charitable and nonprofit organizations of Orange County to have this new outlet, this new opportunity to express themselves and to let the community participate in what is going on in Orange County. This channel, Channel 50, is one of the number 230 now of the National Public Broadcasting System of television stations. Completely non-commercial, public service oriented. It's going to help your local community college district. It's going to help your cultural programs throughout the community. And most of all, it's dedicated to public service and the opportunity for you, the citizen, to get involved, to participate, to make your thoughts known, and most of all, to know what other people are thinking about. Too often in this world today, we do all the talking and listen too seldom. So I hope that you will tune in on Channel 50, get to know what's going on in your community and what makes Orange County a greater and a better way of life for California.
Well, it's a privilege for me to take part in the opening broadcast of station KOCE, Channel 50 in Orange County. There are, of course, many education television facilities in California. We lead the nation in this new field. But from what I've heard about Channel 50, Orange County is in for a real treat. To the station manager, program director, and all the crew at KOCE, I extend my best wishes for success in what I'm sure will be a long and fruitful run.